Oh, hey. What's his face? Fleet. We've barely had to use you this adventure, but I'm using you now. That didn't work. Wait, what? That's how we do it, right? Yeah, Fleet's power. I just did. Like, twice. Okay, let's flip and then use it. Flip. And use it. There, okay, that was the answer, somehow. Also, what is over here? I need to know. This is imperative that I know. Was it? It's nothing. Okay, back through. Got it. No, I don't want to take a damage. Oi! Ah, I took a damage. That's disappointing. Okay, hit this. Hit this. And the way will be opened up. Hey guys and gals, I'm Pal, and welcome back to Super Paper Mario. Last time, we completed after my third attempt, not because I died, but because I kept losing the recording for unknown reasons. I still don't know what caused it, and that's kind of scary. I completed the flip side, Pit of 100 Trials. This time, we are going into the flop side pit. I need to read this. Danger Stay Out, Flop Side, City Hall. Same thing as the last one. So, we're actually going to be switching back to Bowser and Carrie, because Dashelle is not really suited for combat. But Bowser is. We're close to the next level up. This is my inventory. I bought a ton of Long Last Shakes, including a Life Shroom, which I think that's the first time I've bought a Life Shroom in this game. And then I took the rest of my money, which I had about 100 left, sunk it into a gold bar, and stored the gold bar with the shopkeep, because then if I die, I won't lose any money, and I can invest some back into items. Now, I do know there's a recipe with the Flopside restaurant place where you can get something called the emergency ration, which heals 50 HP while inside one of the trials, but I didn't want to invest the time, nor did I want to invest all the money into getting that, as I think my inventory should do the trick. I just have to be really careful and really good at the game. Once you go in, it's not easy to leave. Do you want to go in? Yes, I do. Oh boy, now, I do need to remember that there are shops in here. Also, whoa. What? That's a dark Goomba. They live in the Flopside Pit of 100 Trials. HP is 10, his attack is 2. They're very similar to Goombas, except they're black and somewhat small. Watch carefully and strike. Okay, do they still? They still die in one hit. And this one apparently is welcoming us with the key to the city, which is something I appreciate. Let's go through the door as we see Squirk's face creepily watching us from the wall. Maybe squished into the wall. Whoa. This place is weird. Okay. I wasn't expecting this, and I didn't remember this. Turtly Leaf. Did I have an inventory slot? I did. That's kind of disappointing. Okay, do this. I'll use that Turtly Leaf as soon as possible, just not when I'm fighting Goombas and Koopas. The easiest of enemies. Let's go through the door. I don't expect this to be drastically harder than the last area or the last pit, but I do expect it to step up the difficulty somewhat. And it does seem to be doing that just from sheer number of enemies. Also, the Shadow Cursia that I just saw in the corner of the screen is really concerning because I have no clue what kind of Cursia that is. So it also should be noted, there's my level up, but it also should be noted that it's probably a separate kind of Cursia, because, I mean, if these are Shadow Goombas and they have their own specific stats, then Cursias probably do as well and their own specific status ailment, so I need to be careful of that. Alright, let's go through the door and call it good while I think of something to talk about. Okay, what am I going to talk about while I go through this 100 enemy terribleness thing? Besides just the enemies, because if I talk about the enemies, it's like when you're doing a puzzle, and I mean a jigsaw puzzle, an original puzzle. If you talk about the puzzle, pretty soon you'll hate the puzzle. And if I talk about the dungeon, then I will start to hate the dungeon and start performing worse. So I need to talk about something else. So, like, I don't know, Zelda, I guess. Actually, yeah, this is something I know I get talked about in a failed recording, so I can just reiterate it for fun here. Those Magiblots we discovered in the last area, they actually I had said this at the time, they remind me very much of Phantom Ganon. I mean, besides the fact that they're just magical beings that are phantoms that spawn places, they just kind of reminded me of how Phantom Ganon worked, with how his energy attacks looked. And then I ended up talking on this whole little tirade. Ooh! Okay, there are a lot of enemies that are shadow that take full advantage of that. But I talked about Phantom Ganon, since I've kind of been in a Zelda mood lately. Even though I know it's going to be a long time before I play Zelda on the channel. I've been thinking about Phantom Ganon and just how cool of an enemy he is, because... There's Merlee. Because, I mean, it's the same enemy throughout the entire series, right? You can see that his first appearance... Whoa! Wow. Okay, let's use a Turtley Leaf, but we got a ton of items just now. What do I get rid of? Snap. I could just chuck a Long Last Shake, use the one I just got, and then just kind of attack with Reckless Abandon. That would work. But yeah, Phantom Ganon. We first see him in Ocarina of Time, and he looks just like Ganon, and then he reveals a mask and says, like, hey, bro, I'm actually not Ganon. And he's a cool enemy, and after we defeat him, Ganon pops in, and he says, hey, bro, I'm going to banish you to the space between dimensions, and that's the last we see of Phantom Ganon until some later games. And specifically, Wind Waker, when we see him again, he's completely disheveled and no longer looks like Ganon at all. I mean, besides from his stature, he just doesn't look like Ganon anymore. And it's because of the time he spent in between dimensions, and I just find that really cool. And, I mean, it's kind of subjective whether or not he is a separate, he is his own being that was kind of hired by Ganon, or if he was created by Ganon. But I kind of think that he was hired by Ganon, mainly because he has the intelligence to make an area devoted to himself. And also, if Ganon created him and he failed him, wouldn't he just improve him? I don't know. These were all things I discussed in the failed recording, and I'm really sad that happened, mainly because, as I said, you can't really talk about the pit in this while doing a pit, because you start to hate the pit, and you start to start failing, and because you get bored and stuff. That was not good English, and it was terrible commentary, but it's true. You start performing worse when you start talking about and thinking about everything that you're doing. Okay, let's grab that, grab the item. We're gonna have to chuck the item. So let's not take the item, and Mario, I need your flip ability, so I can flip, go over here, and go to the door. Oh, snap, this is kind of a puzzle. Go through here, I guess, and then we'll have to go through, okay, that wasn't a very hard puzzle, we just have to go through this pipe here. Very good. Now, I love how I had said a couple episodes ago, or a couple recordings ago, that this was quickly becoming, it might become Okami, where I have to do a bunch of pits, and I was like, no, there are only two of these things, and then I have to record the first one three times. Well, I remembered, there actually is another pit. I won't spoil where it is, but there is indeed another pit in this game. And it is indeed 100 rooms. So I'll actually be having to do a Savage Labyrinth type array of... I keep saying array, I don't know why. A Savage Labyrinth formatted area 5 times, which I believe now matches Okami. So yay, I guess. And I know that these aren't the most entertaining things to watch, and there is definitely a subset of my viewers that watches this. But I could speed through it, but I think that if you want to suffer through it like I am, then you should have every right to. Okay, these are the buzzies that break. How far am I till my next level up? Not far at all, actually. I thought it was going to be around 100 thou that I was away from, but no, it's much better than that. Can I not kill you? Well, I hit you, so you turned around. That's nice. Can you guys come over here? Thank you. Nice. I got a couple styles, and I hit him again for the kill, but not the key. Is there a way to go up here? No, there's not. Of course there isn't. There never is. Hello, buddy. And there's the key. Very nice. You can go through this door as it pours out rain outside, which is kind of surprising because the weather was being very gracious. This year, now, obviously I don't expect Washington's weather to match everyone's, but this year is kind of weird for the weather. I mean, we got a lot of rain throughout the summer, but then our spring was really good, and it was a very warm spring, so I don't know. I need Thudley here, or not Thudley, I need Cudge here. Ow. Time it perfectly, and there it is. And there's the key, as I knew would happen. Very nice. Go through the door. We're already to what, room 12? Room 12. So we're making pretty good progress. I want to rush through these as fast as possible. Room 14, okay, sorry. And he's dead. Come on, Paragoomba. Come on, Goomba. I clipped your wings. Get clipped, son. I should add that clip to my highlight reel. I'm sorry. That's an editor's pun. A very weird editor's pun. And I should apologize. But I'm not going to again because puns are good. And it's kind of a Let's Player's obligation to make puns. I think, did Chugga Conroy start that, or is that just a weird thing that's happened? But puns have become very popular of late, even though the saying goes that they're the lowest form of humor. Or is that sarcasm? I don't know. I don't know what the lowest form of humor is. I just do puns, and that's all I care about. Okay, through the door. Very good. Alrighty. This enemy will give me a key. He won't. I was wrong. Down here? Burn? You took a lot of hits. You took two full 18 damage hits, which kind of makes me hope that my next level up gives me an attack bonus, because these enemies have gotten a substantial HP boost, and, I mean, their damage boost doesn't really matter, because, I mean, if you count the amount of hits I've taken, it's very few. I can hit him. Okay. Hoi! Kind of a hard jump to make, but I did. Nice. Get some styles. And one more. I did not think I was going to land that style, but I did. Alright, we'll go down. We need Mario. No, not Peach. Peach, go away with your plant on your head. You think you're so special. Alright. One damage. They still take three hits. Oh boy. Hoi! Barely. I still hit it. Ow! Okay, I totally hit him. And mysterious power makes you jolly. I'm so glad my curse, or my Merly Charm is still going, because it gave me a Vault Shroom, which is one of my favorite items. And, oh, of course. No, I can flip. And it will fall. And there's the key. Snap. What am I going to replace? I can't replace anything. I have all healing items. Okay. Okay, was I just hit by an invisible item? I was, and that's not fair. That is not fair by any means of the word. Any meaning, not means. Go over here and through the door. All right, into the next room. Now, if you notice the cut, first of all, very good eye, because I'm actually pretty proud of that cut there. But if you didn't, then I will understand, because that was a pretty smooth cut right there. I just had to stop to drink some of my ruby grapefruit juice to get some of my voice back, and also recover from the trials and tribulations of this area. I got my key, I should leave. And actually, I got my key, I should use my long last shake right now. Tilt it as shown, like so, there, and there. So I've been thinking of late what I was going to have for the co-op series in between this and the next Let's Play, because Ryan, Dave, Nova, and I originally had actually recorded Dokapon Theater. Whoa, what's this item? Cake mix, okay. We recorded Dokapon Theater. I combined Dokapon with Battle Block to a very, very hilarious mental picture. But Dokapon Kingdom we had recorded, and it was actually pretty fun. It was just, I used my old recording array with, I keep saying array, why do I keep saying array? I have no clue. We'd used my old recording setup with the Sennheisers, and it just didn't sound that good. And also, it was their first time with Dokapon, so it was a little bit confusing for them, and there was a lot of silence as they tried to figure things out, so I ended up just dropping the recording. But then I thought, I might... Normally, I don't really tell you guys this, but I actually don't really mind that much. It's just something I don't talk about, but I'm fine with doing so. I'm thinking I might have a short series of maybe 10 episodes with Ryan and I playing five games of League, and then a set amount of time of Overwatch. I thought that might be fun. Also, Goombario. Isn't he from Thousand Year Door? I don't know. Also, hey Flim, how are you doing? Name's Flim, freelance sales rig, owner and proprietor of this shirt. Sell anything, sell big, do stuff. Shroom Shake, Ultra Shroom Shake, Life Shroom, which I might want to buy. Otherwise, his items are kind of lackluster. So let's see what I can use. Cake Mix. I could use the Cake Mix. Yeah, I'll use the Cake Mix. Nice. And then I think I will just buy... Man, it kind of feels bad buying Life Shroom, but I'm going to do it. I'm definitely going to do it. All yours for 100 coins. Thank you, sir. I definitely appreciate the insurance. I mainly want to take advantage of Flim because I don't think I'm going to see him again, at least for a long time, because we only saw him, I think, once or twice in the area, in the last pit. I don't really want to switch. I just want to kind of avoid this and jump burn. Nice. Got one of these. We'll toss the life shroom. Use the dried shroom. Get hit by this enemy. Bad sequence of events. Ow. Oh, ow. Ooh, ow. 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 No, die. Ow. This hurts. No. No, 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 no. That was very bad. These things are poisonous. Oh, boy. Well, I'm still poisoned. Do I have anything that cures poison? These do, but I don't want to use them. That feels bad. You know what? Sure. It'll heal me back up to full. And it cures poison. That's fine. Okay, and then that gives me one extra inventory slot for item drops, which I immediately get. I should have known that the enemy that poisons me will drop an item that cures poison. That's kind of the trend. Alright, very nice. I think those are poison fuzzies, so I don't want to play around with them. I don't want to get hit, just for the sake of getting hit. Okay, we're up to full health, room 22. More of these, which I don't know why I keep wanting to call them Dweevils, or Twisters make sense, because they're kind of tornadoes, but Dweevils doesn't make sense. It's a Pikmin enemy, and it is not... It does not resemble this in any way, shape, or form. Mario? Flip. Jump over here. Flip. Very nice. Go through the door. The fuzzies always make me laugh here. Whenever you go into the room, they're just kind of... It looks like they're playing a first-person shooter and crouching up and down multiple times. So they're playing Halo or Overwatch or something. Nice. Beautiful styles. And they're just crouching because the developers do that so they don't move, I guess? I don't really know why they're doing that. Ow. Buzzy, you're getting on my nerves. The key isn't, but you are. Alright, we're making good time. We're almost to a level up, which means we should not heal up again. That would be disadvantageous for our item usage. You threw a bone at me. I normally like people throwing me a bone, but not you. Anyone but you. That was cool. Did I actually just cancel the style animation with fire? That seems useful. I'm gonna try that again. That was actually pretty cool. I won't be able to do it on you. Or really anyone in this room. get hit by him, take 6 damage. That hurts. Whoa, avoid that. Trigger that enemy. Come here. Okay. Ow. Ow. Again. Okay. I do not want to play around in this room. I want to get out and leave. Die. How close am I to a level? I'm 6,000 experience. Okay, I can do that. I have 3 life shrooms. I just bought one. Getting styles would definitely help. Getting a pit key would also help. Burning this guy before he has the chance to shoot me would also help. Come here. Come here. You know what? Forget you. I'm just going to go through the door. I don't want to lead him on a merry chase into the open where I can just stomp on him. Okay, more booze. Hit him. Got, oh man. I thought I'd hit him. There we go. Whoa, okay. So many booze. It would probably be better if I used fire. Like that, apparently. Ow, okay. I can take a hint. It's really hard to hit these guys because it's hard to tell when they're coming or going. Whoa, 2 of them. Where are they gonna go? There's the level up, and our attack went up by 1 like I wanted. Good. Okay, they didn't drop a key, though. So this room is all booze, huh? Also, there are the Floro Sapiens there, which are essentially just Pikmin. I really am in the mood for Pikmin, aren't I? Because I reference them every episode multiple times. I just really want to play Pikmin. Go through this door. So we hit our level up. Our attack went up by 1 as I desired. So, dealing a lot more damage. He's dead. Got my coins. Not gaining that many coins because I'm not killing that many enemies anymore. Okay, I don't know why I just stood there and took it. Oh, come on. There you go. No. Get around while I'm invulnerable and just kill him. Flame him to the ground and stomp him while he's down. No coin or no key. Avoid these enemies. Jump attack, fire. Oh, that was beautiful. I loved what happened there. It was like a cinematic cam from Skyrim. Curse-ya. Of course. It's a curse-ya. I'll stop. All right. I got another Merlee thing. Spin the Wheel of Charm. I'm going to wait a little bit longer this time. Hit 2 and a terrible item. Pretty much, well, the shell's probably the worst item I could possibly get from Merlee, but that's a close second. All right, go up here. Now, if you're wondering why I... Well, actually, if you're watching this episode, and very likely you did not watch last episode, then you're probably wondering why I got a pixel last time, Dash L, and I'm not using him. Also, those are... His eyes are Pokeballs. You see that? They're Master Balls, actually. It's odd. That's because Dash L isn't that good... You know, I'm just going to show you. He's not that good in combat, because I can't jump on spiked enemies, and you can see the amount of time that he's actually active is almost non-existent. I mean, he's nice for moving around, but he just doesn't combo that well. Oh, boy. How was I supposed to avoid that? He just doesn't combo that well with Bowser, especially because Carry allows me to do jumping fire attacks, and Dash L does not. So it's more advantageous that I use Carry. Also, she fixes some of the problems that Bowser has, like his aerial movement and his acceleration, because she normalizes that, so everyone using Carry has essentially the same stats, except for the fact that Bowser counts as standing up right now, so he can use fire, and he also does double damage as opposed to the rest of the cast. So it's really, in almost every circumstance, it's better to use Bowser and Carry. And speaking of which, we're going to switch back to them, the happy couple, because technically Bowser and Peach aren't married, because neither one of them really said I do with under their own accord. I mean, Bowser did, but Peach definitely was not happy about getting married. She was kind of brainwashed, or mind control. Brainwashing is being convinced to do something that deep down you want to do, I think. Or being tricked. She was not tricked. She was She was mentally forced to do it, so it's not really brainwashed. Alright. It is brainwashing, kind of, with Bowser's minions, because they already wanted to serve someone, and they're just kind of serving whoever's on top, and mind controls is just kind of an afterthought, so they don't go back to Bowser. Hello, Key. Oh, I know why I've been on such a big Pikmin spree. It's because the keys remind me of challenge mode in Pikmin. And how whenever you have to defeat... Oh, wow, this makes a lot more sense. You have to defeat the enemies for them to drop the keys, which allows you to progress to the next floor. That's why I've been thinking about Pikmin so much. Okay, good. That mystery is solved. Alright, more spring guys. Now, these are not the ones that split into two. And they're also ones that die in one hit. And I'm also low on health, so long last shake. Like I said in the last area, I'm just going to say it again in case you weren't there, or you skipped that or something, or you forgot. It's best if I use my long last shakes first, because they're health regen, and so if I'm taking a lot of damage in a short period of time, they're not useful. But if I'm just walking around like this defeating enemies every now and then, there's the key, then it's advantageous for me to use it. So yeah, it's best to use them earlier on when I'm not taking that much damage. I'm just getting chunked down every now and then. That goes for MOBAs too. Regen is strong against poke, but burst damage is strong against regen. And then poke, ooh. And then poke, no, is good against burst damage. Because then when they go in, they're already at half health. Oh, okay. Dry trim. Okay, good. Well, that's nice. I was able to just heal that up and cure that. Oh, and I got another one. Good. That will be useful. And I already have my key, so let's leave this room forever. Also, I got a level up. So when do I get my next one? I'm guessing 82,000? 81. Or 810. Okay, I killed him. No, not quite. Now he's dead. Oh boy. Yep. I see that game. Let's use Shroom Shake. And kill him real quick. There's a Volt Shroom. And kill these beatboxers. I have no clue what they're called. What are they actually called? Oh wow, that was close. What are they actually called? Tippy? It's a boom. Oh, they are boomboxers. I was right. Well, that's a very appropriate name, because that's exactly what they're doing. Their heads look like boomboxes, and there's Merlee, and there's the key. I rhyme. Just in time. Another Volt Shroom. Okay, I'll start using it. Game, I can take a hint. Even though I think my inventory's full. Oh, let's chuck that. Chuck that. Okay, I meant to use the other thing. Two, A. There. I almost got to max. That's fine. I need to use one enemy, or one anyway, and so I might as well use it in there. Now, does it actually make us faster? Because I felt a little bit faster there. Just as a reminder, we're not invulnerable when using this. We just stun enemies, and touching them doesn't hurt us, so we can just do this. Did I actually kill them there? I'm not sure. It looks like it didn't. It just sent them down below. Oh, hey, what's that? Is it, like... Oh, it's hot sauce. I was actually going to say it was hot sauce, because it looks just like, oh, what's it called? Chipotle. It's Chipotle. So let's use this. My attack is increased. Pick up the dried shroom. Can't believe that I prefer that over some other item. Kill the Cursia. Yeah. Kill him. We're dealing 40 damage, which feels quite good. And we're to the end of this room. I haven't actually been paying attention. What room number are we up to now? Let's see. We're up to room 36, almost halfway. Whoa, okay. Another snap. I don't like burning through items this quickly. Tilted is shown. And done. Now, I actually have a question. Oh, I don't want to die here. Are the pits of 100 trials like this in other... Actually, yeah, this is a very good question. Are they like this in other Paper Mario games? Because... obviously they're not, because it's... oh, oh, oh boy. It's an RPG battle! And, or are there pits in one, of 100 trials in those games? Just remember, I have this. Let's use this real quick, just to bolster our health quickly. And we're to... yeah, okay, so it's a wild soul level. Very nice. But yeah, how are they formatted in those games? Oh boy. Oh boy, we just lost two. Kill him quick! Yeah, we just lost two, oh, those were only two. Okay, then. Things just got a little bit more interesting. Let's use our long last shake as I start to worry about whether or not I can complete this without having to get, emergency rations, which heal a lot more in the Pit of 100 Trials. Oh, boy. My HP will now regenerate. As soon as I get into the next room, I'm going to use a Volt Shroom and hope that I hit a level up pretty quickly. What's in here? Okay, Volt Shroom. Press the flashing button. One, one, A, one, one, A, one, one, two, two. Max charge. Does that just increase the duration, or I don't know if that actually changes. What's going to spawn in here? Magiblots? No. Oh. Oh, it's just these. Ooh, that's nice actually. Oh man, I might just wait for these to finish. Because they give a lot of experience. Yeah, I think I might do that. Let's go to the other side, because I'm about to get hit. Yeah, this is good for me. Is there a way for me to get on the other side of them so I can fire? No, I think I'm just going to wait here. Just, let me cut ahead. Alright, there are a bunch of enemies here. Let's see how much experience this gives me. Oh, I need carry. Let's wait for that one to go to the side so I can jump and fire. Oops. Let's kill these. Will I get hit? No, I won't. Very nice. Now let's go to the other side. And rinse and repeat. How many have spawned over here? A couple. I don't think they spawn off screen, so that explains that. Oh, never mind. There were a lot more than I thought. That gave us some experience, so we're closer to a level up. We're still 40,000 away, but that's, you know, it's not what it was when we first came in this room. Whoa, poison. I don't want poison. Poison is bad. So is being frozen. Although it was only 4 damage for being frozen, so it's really meant to just guarantee other enemies to hit me. And as you can see here, I'm not going to be rushing through. Ooh, I got a peach. Because of item drops and because of experience. And these enemies are easy enough that I can kind of do a little bit of farming and get another drop. Ooh, that's nice. That's really nice. Okay, so this room was worthwhile. It essentially gave me 45 HP, because the combined items that I got here is about 45, I think. And this room, oh boy, we haven't seen these enemies in a while! This would have been a much better room to use my Volt Shroom in. Okay, stomp him. These are easier boots because they only take one hit. Grab the key. Oh, wait, we don't have another life shroom, so peach. Also, it was 40 HP, not 45. Burn them real quick. Ah, and yes, this is a good item. All right, this enemy takes one damage, really. Just hit him. Be very careful. Ow. Oh boy, this is dangerous. Yeah, you take that damage. Oh boy. No. Super shroom shake. Please don't hit me, sir. I should not have gone in a tight space. I should just leave while I'm still ahead. Oh wow. This area is starting to get hard. Once I hit, oh, Flim, please be here. Flim, no Flim, okay. On room 50, if Flim's there, I'm buying every item I can get from him. Even if it's something crazy expensive. I have 200 coins. I need the items. I also need Merlee to proc more. Okay, more of these guys. Kick that at me. Jump over it. Kick it down. Whoa! Hit him. Throw that away. Got the key, so if need be, I can leave. Nice. I'm invulnerable while doing that, essentially, from them. And I'm just going to leave, because these enemies are hard. I did not get hit by one, but I assume it's going to deal somewhere around the lines of 10 damage. I don't want that. Okay, Boomer. Hit that, and while that happens, I'm just going to kind of survey what else is here. Curcia, more of those enemies. Can you turn around, sir? Ma'am? You? Thing? You? Turn around. Eat this yummy bomb. Okay, you're still alive. Eat this yummy bomb. You must really like spicy food, because you're dead now. People who like spicy food, like myself, die. But everyone kind of dies, but we'll ignore that. Okay, Cursey dies in one hit. Are there any Curseys that haven't died in one hit? Or do they just seem to share stats and not status ailments? Okay, Boomer, get back here. But that's an important question. And 1,000 experience and some coins. And another one of these things. Eat it. And eat it. Burn that other one fire, and there's the key. Let's get Carrie back. And leave. Whoa. Not so fast, buddy. Not so fast. I don't like those enemies. They're actually pretty hard to hit. Same with these ones, because if they're in a line or in a tight space like this, then they can be really hard to approach. You pretty much just have to come at them when their back's to you. Did not get a style there. Ooh, burn. They also do a lot of damage. Okay, I did get the key, but at this point I can hit them and kill them pretty easily for some free points. So close to a level up, which will heal me to full, so I'll try not to take damage, and I'll try not to have to use a healing item. Instantly dies. Hello, Curcia. You're dead to me. Let's see. There's the door. Go down here. Ooh, jump on these enemies. Did not get a style, but that's fine. He's dead. Any more? Yes, there are volunteers to die, which is the worst kind of volunteer. Okay, up here, down here, and to the left. Okay, what are we gonna see now? More of these guys? Well, that's fine. I'm actually kind of content to fight these enemies now. Before I wasn't, but the fact that they can't really hurt me is nice. While that happens, I can reflect on how my life has led up to this moment. How this game is almost over, actually. We only have a handful of episodes left before I'm going into the after game, which there is a little bit of after game from what I remember. But it's nothing too much. And then we're going into the next Let's Play, after the co-op Let's Play, which there is always a co-op Let's Play. Oh boy. Let's try and jump up here. But yeah, after this Let's Play is actually, it's actually one I've been really hyped for. And then, after that, what was I going to do? Oh yeah, it's going to be a fairly short LP, but one that is a long time coming, and then, also I'm so vague, so you're not really being told anything. After that is actually going to be a very long game, from what I understand, that I've never played before, and that'll be interesting, because you guys seem to like this Let's Play a lot, for whatever reason, and I think that maybe that reason is that it's kind of blind. Oh, this room's terrible. I hate this room already. You see this? This is awful. Let's start. Actually, let's grab that. Yeah. Ghost room would be so useful right now. Okay, point at the screen. Practice my Okami swirls. And then after the long game that I can't name that I've never played before is actually... Get up here, ghost room. Ghost room. Get over here. Is going to be one of my childhood games. Oh boy. Yeah, this. Stupid ghost room isn't doing anything. I thought it would be really useful, but it's actually, the AI for it is really dumb. You can miss that? Okay. I tilted it the right way, but whatever. Oh, come on, Ghost Shroom. Get up here. I can't get by this. Do you see this? I cannot possibly get by this. I mean, I can rack up some points, but that's it. Actually, I can rack up points. Do you see this? This is infinite points right here, even though it's very slow. It's still infinite. That's kind of nice. Or did they stop? No, I'm still getting points. There goes the Ghost Room, because it was stupid as garbage. Don't hit me, bro. When can I go? Right now. Nice. I killed one. No, don't have your back to it. That's bad, pal. Burn him, and burn him again. Level up! Nice! I'm up to max HP, and my HP went up by 5. That's good. That's a relief. Even though my item's kind of wasted, still kind of farming with those hammer bros was beneficial. Okay, I have the key, so let's go into the door with max HP, but not max items. I have 3 healing items left, so and the level up's far from now, so I need to make the best use possible out of this HP here. Okay, boomerang bros, they can't attack me through walls, though it looks like the designers thought they might be able to. Kill him. Nice. He's dead. Ooh, cake mix. I'm about to get hit. Turn around, run! And burned. Boom roasted. No, yeah, I hit him, and I hit him again. Good. When's our next level up? Just out of curiosity. 90,000 experience away. But we'll still get it. We'll still definitely get it in this pit. I don't really doubt that we won't, because we're halfway done, and there is a boss, there probably is a boss. I don't see why there wouldn't be a boss. Once again, this game is blind, and this is my first recording of the Flopside Pit, so there's probably a boss. It's probably formatted similarly to the Flipside Pit. So maybe it's another Fractail Racktail type deal, but maybe not, I don't know. Okay, let's kill the fire bros. There's the key. Where was the door? Was it? No, it wasn't here. Where was that? Yeah, okay, that's not fair. He hit me through the wall. That's not intentional, I don't think. That's intentional. And so is this. Doorway. Yeah, use the pit key. Go through the doorway. Get to room 50. What is this? 50, 49. Get instant key, instant clear. Easy game, easy life. Okay, will Flim be here? This is the real test. I'm going to start with the chest to rack up suspense. Is it another paracarry? Okay. No Flim. I wonder. Is Flim? Flim's really not there. Okay, that's disappointing and kind of sad, but I think I can make it through 10 more rooms on the inventory I have now. If not, then that was a sent. Ooh, you haven't seen these guys in a long time. Okay, but they can't actually get out. And also, they're stuck. Oh, they can get out. Okay, but fire. Yeah, you try it. Oh, I just remembered. These guys give me a ton of experience, right? What do they give? And coins. Also, what is your HP? 2,500 experience for one enemy that I didn't take any damage from. Now, granted, if there's a swarm of those guys, it'd be scary, but that's a lot of experience. Also, more chain chomps. And a lot more experience, actually. Technically, these guys give a much higher gain. I got the key. Let's go up here. Oh, there's the thing. Ah, I went through too early. No. I should have looked. And there's only 2 of these guys here. That's kind of odd. They're just 2 chain chomps. And one of them is almost pretty much impossible to get to, so I'm glad I didn't have to defeat that one to get the key. Alright. Oh boy. More clubbas, which did I get? I mean, they're dark clubbas, so I probably didn't get the catch card bonus against them. But they're pretty easy enemies, just they take a while to kill. They're also pretty cute, which we've talked about before. Now, are they Bowser's underlings? This is a good question, because they don't really seem to be in any other Mario game. Okay, 1,000 experience, and stomp on him so I could get the potential style, but I did not. Let's kill him too, because these, if there are easy enemies, I should probably stay and kill them, because they're easy enemies to kill. And it's experience that is at no risk for me to be getting. Okay, go through the door, and, oh boy, this is, this is probably a bad idea, but I'm recording this directly after I did the recording of the Flipside Pit, so I'm already wary of enemies, and I've already exhausted what I'm talking about, and I, by all rights, I should have sped this up, oh boy, but I did not. Instead, I'm just forced to be talking about the cave, which I said is a bad idea. I took a lot of damage from that. I should not take that much damage. Okay, come on. Come on. Ow, 8 damage is not good. Okay, through the door. We're not close to a level up, so long last shake. Tilt it right, pal. Tilt it right, tilt it well, tilt it down, tilt it up. Down, down, up. Very good. That'll bring me up to 54 HP. And then, hopefully actually, we haven't seen Merlin long enough. Our charm may have run out, because we haven't run into that charm in a long time. That would have dealt a lot of damage. 1,000 experience. Every enemy is giving at least 1,000 now. Which is interesting. Hopefully that trend continues. And also, hopefully we run into Flim so we can actually spend our hard-earned cash. Emphasis on hard-earned. Nice. That was kind of a cheap hit, but whatever. I still got the key instantly. And I got through the door instantly. Is that a boomerang bro? Yeah, that's a boomerang bro down there. Although it looks like something weird is behind him. I don't know what's up with that. Okay, more of these things. They're very fast. They don't outrun fire, though. Whoa, maybe they do. Whoa, and they also take a lot of hits. Oh, boy. They take 2 hits. Something to be aware of. Oh, boy. Got him. All right. We're already halfway to our next level up, which is a relief duck. Will it hit him? It won't. Okay, but I still ducked under the damage. Oh, wait. Back up. There. Now I should be able to kill these guys. Yep, there's the key. Okay. And any item drops? None. Got it. But I got the key and through the next door. I mean, if I ever wanted to get my fill of fighting in this game, this is the way to do it for sure. And I mean, it is fun. I do like how it's using a platformer like the Super Mario series as a fighting game, because it is fun, ow. It is fun to kill enemies. And, ooh. Also, ow, ooh, ow, ow, ow. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. 2 more hits and I'm dead. Yeah, it is fun to use the platformer style to actually fight enemies, because that is enjoyable. Okay, do this. Nope, nope. Jump up. Ow. Such a cheap shot. Okay, you're just going to do that. I'm just going to run into you with Barry. Because I don't like you. No! There. Die. Thank you for dying. Ah. That, I took way too much damage. Now I'm worried. But yeah, I do like this the fighting style. It is kind of hard when your inventory is so limited. Ooh, it's so limited, and I'm down to my last item, and I'm all over halfway through. We're at 55. No, we're at 60. Okay, Flim, please be here. Please be here. I don't know if I can make it through another room. He's not here. Oh boy. Oh, I'm concerned about my well-being and whether or not I'll get a game over. Avoid that. Now, I need to remember that Barry does reflect these projectiles, so I'm going to switch to him now. Ow! Cheap shots, once again. Yeah, you taste that. You taste the cheap shots. Okay, there's the key. Okay. Shoot at me. Shoot at me so you can get shot back at with the red fox shine from Melee and pretty much all the games. There. He's dead. Now, how do we kill you? Oh, wait. No. I have a better idea. I have a much better idea. Key's up there, right? Right? We don't want to deal with the key, right? Right? Well, we don't have to. We can just grab it and go through the door. That was using my brain noggin with my 15 HP. Though, I am closer to a level up, so I might get it. We do have Barry equipped. Let's just do this. There. Reflect it. He'll take 12 damage. Reflect it. He'll take 12 damage. Okay, now there's that enemy, which I should switch to carry for. And burn, though I need to be careful that there was a glitch or something with this enemy where it warped Bowser. I have no clue why, but it did warp Bowser with a glitch earlier in the LP, so I need to be careful of those enemies, because they could warp me into them and then just insta-kill me, so I don't know. I don't know how to avoid it, but I feel like just using fire is the best way. Oh boy. Super Shroom Shake, last healing item. Okay, instantly got the key. At this point, I just want to kind of run through. Oh boy. Door's up there. Go through the door. Yes. Okay. Oh, this is kind of iffy because I'm close to a level up, which means I could stay and defeat enemies. But oh boy, I'm far enough away from a level up and I have no healing items that I have nothing to do if I'm getting a sticky situation. Okay, he's dead. He's dead. Please drop some item or get Merlee. I do not want to have to deal with that. Okay, there's the key. So let's grab the key. And burn him. Where's the door? I think it's up. There. Okay. Yeah, nice try. Oh, boy. Got some points from destroying the shurikens. Okay, run into my fire. Run into my fire. Oh, he did. Okay, now he's going to spawn there. And die with 1,000 experience. Getting close. I just need to whittle him down. Just kind of go to some guerrilla warfare tactics. Kill the enemies that I can kill. And run away from the ones that I can't. This is an example of things that I can't kill. That's an unfair arrangement of enemies. I want to see if I can possibly kill any other enemy. Oh boy. And kill any other enemy to get some experience. And okay, he's going for that one. And burn. Nice. Insta-killed him. Run from the fire. Okay, there's the key. There's the key. There's the key. Grab the key. Key that gives no points. Where is... Can I hit him? No, I can't. That was dumb. That was so dumb, pal. Oh boy. I'm so low. This was where the door was. I should have remembered that. Okay, stay vigilant. Don't tap to attack. Just be safe, and you don't have to die. No one has to die here. I could farm off this, actually. Oh, I might just do that. I do have a time limit. But, and also I'm really far away, and 10 is not going to do anything. So, let's do that. Take a hit of 4. I have no items. I have none. I guess I'm gonna farm just a little bit. Just a little bit. Let's see. Let me check. It's 90,000. I'm kind of close. Maybe. A little bit. And I'm getting like 40 or 50 per second. So that's good. Maybe. Oh, boy. Run over here. Oh, I can't even get that enemy. Unless... I use Barry. And time it well. That did not work. No. No! Kill him! Quick! Kill him! No! Kill him! No! Kill him! I'm dead. Man! Oh no. Oh boy. So close. And a bow card. I'm just going to start this back up on room 60 here, because I don't actually remember which room I died. Maybe it was 63, something like that, so maybe there will be a couple rooms rehashed, but that's fine. My inventory is a little bit better, because before I started the Pit of 100 Trials this time, I went and grabbed and refreshed my Merlee Charm. Now, I didn't get the best one. I couldn't actually afford it, so I got the middling one, but it's been serving me rather well, and I have 3 life shrooms because of it, and a bunch of Thunder Rages. The Thunder Rages I got from enemies, not from Merlee, so I should be able to fare a little bit better this time, because whenever I get into trouble, I'll just use my Thunder Rage. Also, I found out that Boomer is out. You know what, actually, I'm gonna use my Thunder Rage now, because I was gonna say Boomer's really good against, the Chain Chomps, but there are Kameks here, and those are so annoying. So let's kill them. Nice. It didn't actually kill the Kameks, that's odd. But I guess I can deal with that. Let's dodge that. I could reflect it back at them, but I feel like just outmaneuvering them is better than actually trying to get the timing right. So there you are. Let's switch to Mario. Another thing that I found off screen, switching to Mario is actually a really good thing to do if I ever need help, or not help, if I ever need to get out of a sticky situation, I can just switch to Mario and then have him flip into 3D, and it's a really great get out of jail free card. So I'll be doing that a lot, actually, rather than getting stuck in kind of a crowd of enemies taking damage. I can just switch to Mario by freezing time and then flip into 3D because I'm invulnerable for the entirety of that animation. So yeah, let's kill these weird square things, which their names still elude me, and I could look it up, but I really just want to kill them. And then avoid the Kamek. Man, their attacks are actually really good. Burn him? They're really good mainly because attacking them does not interrupt the attack. So, like, half the time it still goes off, and you don't expect it. And it's big. It's big enough so it's hard to dodge, and it's slow enough that it takes up an entire alley. It's like a Symmetra right-click in Overwatch, which I should really just show some Overwatch and League content on the channel. Is there a guy? There is. Let's jump up here. Flame him? Okay, not, maybe not. Let's see, what do I have? I don't have any more long last shakes. I'm kind of far from a level up. Ow, okay, yeah. Lesson learned, use this. And, whoa, hello. I can hit you with Kudge, right? Maybe. Well, I can hit you down here with Kudge, I know that, so there you go. I missed him. Well, I didn't miss him, but he has more hit points than that. I can't hit him, can I? Okay. Let's switch back to carry then. Hit this guy as he goes by. I'll hit him with fire, then jump on him. Oh, he's dead. Okay. More Kameks. You know what? I think I will reflect these ones' attacks, because it is kind of hard to get in there. Nope. Please die. Nice. Almost dead. Good. Now they're both dead. Switch to Mario. Flip before I get into trouble. Grab the key, and the door is this way, right? I think it is. Oh, well, that's problematic. Use berry. Oh, that was close. Use berry. There, he's dead. That was so close. I didn't know what that curse you did, so it could have been very bad. Let's switch to Bowser and kill that real quick, just because I want the extra experience, because I'm kind of getting close to a level up. I mean, I'm halfway to a level up, so that'll be nice. Oh, more ninjas. Okay, this is a situation where I actually don't want to mess around. I just want to Thunder Rage. Okay, shake it up and down, and hopefully it'll get that ninja on the side. It looks like it will. Will it kill them? No, they're all alive. Okay. Well then. And let's just spam Barry because he's reflecting projectiles. Okay, that went pretty well. Thunder Rage. Yes. Yes, that's very good. That's actually just as good as a healing item. Okay, let's grab Carry. I do have a life shroom, and I'm not taking that much damage from these guys. Oh, never mind. I'm taking a lot of damage from these guys. Let's use a super shroom shake. Burn him, grab the key, and get out of here. The ninjas can be some of the harder enemies, because once you get enough of them, it's hard to dodge their attacks, hard to see where the bombs are happening, especially since everything's ink blotted black, so it's good just to get out of dodge. And avoid these enemies. Burn this guy. Get a big egg. Oh, that's nice. Easiest way to kill him. Let's actually use a very old strategy. Do this. Switch to throw. Grab Boomer. And throw. That worked very well. And how about these guys? How are we going to deal with them? Oh, I just realized he can hit me through the wall. So I need to run. Because if he throws fire right now, I think he will hit me through the wall. So I need to avoid that. Alright, up here, in case you're wondering, that's how close I am to a level up. Okay, he's dead. Whoa, boy. Can't burn you. The one thing I found I could do is wait till he attacks. There you go. Oh, never mind, I can't. Well, another thing I found I could do is jump this fire, place a bomb, wait for him to attack, and blow him up for the key. And speaking of the key, oopsie, wrong button. I can flip, jump all the way down, and go through the door. I got a Thunder Rage, so I'm probably going to be using it in this next area. What enemy is here? More of these, so yeah, I probably will use it. Ow! Ooh, ow. That hurts. I don't really want to use a Thunder Rage on these guys. Let's go for the boomer throw strategy. Because that would get it right in where I want it to be. I missed. Okay. Let's try that again. Maybe with a little hoppy hop this time. I have to be very cautious around these guys, because if I get in their range, then that means usually... Okay, I don't think I can actually hit them. That means usually I will get hit multiple times. So let's do this. Switch to Bowser. And burn. And get a little bit of a free experience. Wait for them to walk into range. I'm content doing this, man. I mean, with how much experience I'm getting from the hammers, as well as just killing them, I'm not going to take the extra risk of taking damage. I'm just going to hold down the down button. Okay, there's one guy above. Oh boy. Big egg. Heal 12. Burn him. And get in on this guy. Nice. Where is the key? Where's the key going to drop? Oh, there are two of them up there. Of course there are. Easiest way to deal with them is just to go around manually. Oh my goodness, I do not like Hammer Bros. How do I get to them? I'm tempted to just Thunder Rage right now. Maybe... Not Barry. Barry is a dumb idea. You know what? Yeah. Boomer Throw. That seems the most effective, and it's my longest range attack, so... Did I get him? No, I did not. Oh, I can grab a hammer? Well, it's terrible. It has terrible range, so that's not a strategy. What would Fleep do? Nothing. Okay. You know what? Yeah. I'm just going to use Thunder Rage because there's no way I could get in on those enemies, and without taking a couple hits, and a couple hits is too much. So let's just take care of them, like clockwork. They're still alive. Of course they are. Stinking course they are. Okay, let's try to establish a foothold here. And get Merlee. Okay, that's nice. What are we gonna get? A garbage item. Okay. Well, actually, no, no item's garbage by this point. Oh, that was bad. Let's heal up. This is not looking good again. I may die again. Let's grab this, because no item is useless, and now I have two attacking items, which I will spam in the next room, because if I can use these items to get more drops, then I will. This room seems fairly easy. Just burn him. Attack them. Of course, as soon as I say that's easy, something will happen. There will be booze, maybe? No, it looks like it's just these guys, which is nice, because I'm nearing a level. And I've hardly ever taken damage from these enemies, so... Howdy, Clubbos. And also, curses are pretty easy. It's just when they're mingled with certain enemies that they're hard, so... I'll happily take the free experience and get to the next room. My only problem is that unless I get a level up, I'm going to be heading into the final, assumed boss room with very low HP. 68, okay. Did not get a style like I wanted. I shook the controller like crazy, but it's pretty unresponsive at times. Okay, one of those guys. Let's just hit it. Nice. Hit them both at once. And again. And they're dead. Cool. Kill this Clubba. He drops the key. Now, normally I would say, okay, I'm peace out, but these enemies are easy. All I have to do is hold down and kill them for a free 1600 experience. So I'll do that. And kill him. Nice. Alright, kill him. Very good, 1600 free experience. I am close, very close to the next level up, which will bring me up to, I assume it's going to level up attack, though it might level up HP. Did it level, have I gotten this level before? I don't think I have in the failed thing. Oh boy, yep, going to use fire. Going to use fire, shake it up and down. Now this item deals, oh, there's a Thunder Rage right there. So while they're taking damage, I will quickly run and grab that Thunder Rage. Good. Whoa, run! Okay, there's one of these flying enemies, which means the POW block won't work. But the Thunder Rage will. Should I, well... Actually, I'll use my own advice. And say peace out. You see how well that strategy works? Just, if you're able to pause while in trouble, just switch to Bowser, or I mean switch to Mario, and flip, and avoid everyone's attacks. It's like you can become Neo, and it's quite nice. Okay, burn him. Get a Sleepy Sheep. Now normally I'd scoff at such a thing, but Sleepy Sheeps could be pretty useful. Ow. In fact, I'm just gonna use it right now. Just because... Oh, hold it. Okay. Because no item is useless at this point. Even if I'd rather have a healing item, Sleepy Sheeps, I don't know, they may save my life. They may prevent me from dying here. I don't know. Though, did anything fall asleep? Oh, he did. Hey, buddy. Get the biggest hit in possible. Never mind. Yeah, biggest hit possible. This. Bang! That was one damage. Okay. I know that. What doesn't work? Switch to berry. So when he tries to hit me, I can just do that. Okay. He's a hard enemy to deal with. This weird thing. We've only seen a couple in the game, but they give a ton of coins. So I won't scoff at it, but still, they're hard to defeat. Okay, let's flip. Go over to the other side. How many healing items do I have? I have a couple. Let's just use that right now. Get back into the safe zone. Okay, jump up here. Hey, buddy. Ow. That was rude. Whoa. Ow, that did not hurt me, actually. Man, they move so quickly. What are you even supposed to do against that? That's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to use berry and just smile at them. Okay. There's another enemy. Let's switch to carry because I feel as slow as a tanker. Ow. Ow, 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 ow. See what I'm talking about Bowser? If you get hit once, you're going to be hit again. I guarantee it. And he's going to spawn there. And he's going to burn. Nice. 1,000 points. I'm fairly close. I don't want to say I'm really close, because I'm not. It's, you know, it's 10,000 experience, but I'm fairly close to the next level up. Now, does that mean I won't be able to, I won't have to use another healing item? No, I probably will. Unless I see Flynn. Hopefully Flynn is here. I would be so happy if I saw Flynn, because I have around 400, I have 500 coins. No Flynn. Okay. I don't see why they give you so much money. Also, I turned Italian there for a moment. They give you so much money and nowhere to spend it, but it is what it is. I won't complain because this Pit of 100 Trials, it's supposed to be difficult. Okay, room 71. What does it have in store? What is that down there? One of those. Okay, well, we can switch to Mario. And get behind him. Switch. Get out Bowser. And burn both of them. And they give a lot of experience. Oh, no, they only give 1,000. Okay. I mean, that is a lot, but I thought they gave a lot more. A substantial amount more than 1,000. Okay, so what room are we up to? We're in the 80s, right? 80s or 90s? 70s. Really? Okay. Get a couple styles. And kill this guy in the most hilarious fashion possible. Please die. Man, he was tough. Not for me, but he was tough. He was tough in the sense he had a lot of HP. Both of you can be together, burning. Got a turtly leaf, which is still good. And... ow. Okay, that was kind of bogus. Burnt that thing. And burnt this thing. A lot of coins. I have 500 coins. So if I die, I'll be mighty mad. But I'm about to get a level up, so I'm probably not going to die. And yes, I can safely say now that I am about to get a level up. Because I'm 2,400 experience away from getting my level up, which will be glorious. So maybe 3 enemies? 4 tops? But more likely 3. Maybe even 2. 2 to 4 enemies. And if they're... what is this? Whoa, you're new. You are new! What are you? What are you? It's a dark berry bad. They live in the flopside pit of 100 trials. HP is 12, attack is 3. It creates an impenetrable barrier around itself. You can't break the barrier, but you can beat them with Bowser's fire, which is what I've been using the entire area anyway. So, fire. Oh, they deal a lot of damage. Is there another one? No. Okay, well, I can take a... I can maybe... I'll definitely take one more hit. And beyond that, I have 3 life shrooms, so I'm fine with that. I might even just use the turtly leaf in this next area, just as kind of a buffer. No, these enemies are easy, unless they warp me, which they've been known to glitch and do that. I'll never trust these enemies again because of that weird glitch. Although that was probably more related to the anti-gravity of the woe zone that caused that. There's my level up! My attack went up by 1. Well, that's decent, I mean. That means my fire will be dealing more damage, so... That's something that's definitely appreciated. But also, I'm up to max health, so... My next level up is at 100,000, so in 10,000 experience? Or is that... wait, that's 1,000,000. Oh, so in 100,000... yeah, 100,000 experience, I will get another level up. So that's pretty far away. But I might get it. I'm guessing that I'm going to need it get it when I need it most. And by that, I mean the final room. Okay, kill him, get the key. Switch to Mario. Flip. And we're in good shape here. Let's see, how do I get over there? With a pipe? Yeah, with a pipe. So I actually took a wrong turn. I need to get over here and then through the pipe. And there we go. Oh, I'm actually feeling kind of... I mean, I probably shouldn't be feeling confident considering I have 1 real healing item left, but I'm feeling kind of confident. And that's actually kind of scary because I should not be feeling confident, but maybe they'll help me perform better. What is... okay, that's one of the sleepy enemies. Woohoo! Avoid him. Burn you, avoid you. Okay, what I'm going to do is, as soon as he comes back around, I'm going to do that. Yep, there you go. And hold up my fire. It's going to come back, and I'm going to get a ton of coins. Why are you sparkly? I actually want to know this. It's a dark daisy. Anything. They look happy. The dark ones are usually scowling. You can't tell because they're cloaking shadow. Too bad. Okay, so nothing special. Oh, he can flip. That's probably why. Okay. So is he going to flip back? Run, jump. And nice. I handled that very well. Now the daisy, though, I have to chase after in 3D. Whoa. Hello. And he flips again. Okay, interesting. Oh, he runs fast. Ow. He doesn't deal any damage. I mean, he deals one damage, but... And he's gonna run into 3D. Wow, you're fast. You're fast, buddy. Hey. Oh, he runs. Oh, that's what it is. He doesn't just run fast. He sees us and then runs fast. That's cool. Avoid the... That. And... Kill him. Jump. Get a style. Not a style. But... I did get a lot of coins. Whoa. Wait. Really? Really? Do not make me laugh as I did just now. You're going to die. And you're dead. That was hilarious. And also a product of me flipping into 3D. And he just fell onto the pipe in the corner of the screen and then stayed there. Okay, I'm happy with that, with my 600 coins. And he's dead. Another Thunder Rage. That's good. That's good news. Kill you guys. Get a lot of coins. And burn. The good thing is that these enemies, unlike the Sammer guys, they don't know to avoid your fire. The Sammer guys do, but these guys are a little bit more stupid, so... Or a little bit less intelligent. That's a more polite way of saying it, though both are not very polite and don't say that to other people, but still, they're not that intelligent AI, so you can just kind of spam fire and call it good. Okay, I'm pretty much invulnerable when I use fire against most of these ninja guys. I just have to watch out for the bomb attack. And also stepping on the shurikens, because that does deal damage. Hello, goodbye. Oh, wow, I ducked under you. That was interesting. Let's kill these guys first. That was easy. Okay, so these are the easy enemies that I probably have a catch card for. I mean, maybe I don't have one for the dark ones, but... Hey, buddy. Jump on you. And burn you. Where are you going to spawn? You're going to spawn there? You're going to spawn there. And now you're dead. He lived again. Now he didn't. I have 600 coins. I have no clue what I'm going to spend these coins on, but please tell me. Like, give a suggestion in the comments of what I can spend all this money on. Also, I am close. Well, I'm not. I keep saying that. I am seeing the next level up is in sight. It's not that unreachable. So I will reach it in this cave. And I think maybe my boost in confidence is partially due to the fact that. Everything seems to have gotten a lot easier. You see this? I mean, you have enemies that can't reach me. Like, I mean, there are no projectiles being thrown around besides the shurikens, which I can just flame away. And I have Merlee, which is great. Hopefully I get a healing item, because I have enough damaging items. I get a Volt Shroom, okay. Well, that's not the worst thing. I have a lot of attacking items, which I should probably start using. But, yeah, things are going pretty well, all things considered. Alright, one of these guys. I actually want to bio them, because they have a cool staff. A Skelobit. They dwell in the Flopside Pit of 100 Trials. HP is 30, attack is 4, defense is 4, don't stomp on that spear. It only attacks with its sphere, so use throw to toss it. But the low ceilings may make it hard to throw them very far. Okay, interesting. Alright, sorry for the cut there, I just had to deal with something. I've been recording for a long time, and I'm actually enjoying it. I mean, I was kind of upset with the game for having to re-record, but for some reason I'm enjoying it right now, so it's the grinding lover in me. I actually love grinding in video games. I don't It's a weird thing, but I do enjoy it quite a lot. In fact, I remember, my goodness, so many hours spent just grinding in Fire Emblem Awakening on two separate lunatic, sorry, I almost called it by my pet name for it, lunatic plus runs. I had maxed out every character in the game. Every character, even the ones that you get that are really bad, I maxed them out. Every class, every skill, they were completely maxed. And I remember so many times just me memorizing the button inputs for farming in that game and just watching TV while farming. Okay, let's get Carrie back while I talk about how easy these enemies are right now. Another POW block, okay. I would love to have a healing item just for the insurance of it, but I understand. I'll happily take some damaging items. Let's jump over here with a very annoying sound that I'm probably driving you crazy with, but that's fine. You guys knew you were going to be driven crazy by me from the very moment that I got on Skyward Sword and said, I don't do gutter speak here. You remember that, because everyone that watched my channels watched Skyward Sword, Kappa. You haven't. I know you haven't. I don't expect you to, because Skyward Sword, it wasn't for everyone. It's definitely an old Let's Play, and it was not my best. I'm going to have to flip. It was not my best by any means, or shape, or form of the word. I was still new. That was my first Let's Play. And most of my viewers at that time were people I knew personally. Ooh. Let's toss the Thunder Rage. And use the Peachy Peach? Yeah, let's use the Peachy Peach. Back up to max HP. Are you kidding me? What is this? Oh, okay. They're giving me Kamex. That makes sense. They should make it a little bit more difficult. Whoa. I actually interrupted the attack. And he's dead. Nothing here. No keys have dropped yet. I'm almost up to 700 coins. I'm almost up. I'm halfway to my next level up. I don't want to use that pipe. I'm just going to flip. Go over here. Flip. And ow. That hurt, but it's not something that I can't live with. I still have more HP in this area, leaving this area than when I started. So that's a good thing. Let's see, what room are we at right now? I legitimately have not been paying attention. We're up to room 80-something? 83, okay. That's respectable, I guess. It's not 93, but it's not like I'm that concerned. Also, I just realized how comfortable I am with playing Bowser at this point, that I would have missed... I would have missed those jumps had I used Mario, but I missed them anyway. Hey! An ice storm. That's useful. And wow. Let's toss this and actually use the POW block. Okay, shake it with good timing. Oh. With good timing, not just shaking it like crazy. Now granted, POW blocks deal next to no damage. Did it actually deal no damage? Really? Really? I have not seen that happen before. I thought that items were guaranteed to deal at least one damage. Interesting. Also, he hit me there a couple times, which is not good. Haha! Get thee wrecked! And you! Oh, another ice storm! Which means I'm going to be getting... Oh, wow. These are good items. Toss this. Oh, snap. Nope, refresh this. Throw it. And I'm actually just going to blank my POW block right now. And then because if it doesn't deal any damage and it was dealing one damage about five times anyway, it's just not useful anymore. So let's use this. Defense is increased, which is actually that is quite useful. Even though it's just a turtly leaf and you get those in the beginning of the game, it is a useful item. I'm not gonna kill that guy. Because probably for my next hit, I'm going to be taking zero damage, or maybe close to that. So it's definitely good. Okay, these guys are easy to kill. And another Merlee thing. Please give me a healing item. That would just make me a little bit more comfortable. Of course not. You give me a Volt Shroom. Okay, I see how it is. burn you? And what can I throw away? Man, I actually have to throw things away now. I might just throw away the vault shroom that I just got. Because Ice Storm seems really useful. Ghost Shroom, I mean, yes, his AI's awful, but he can be useful. Ow! And he can rack me up points, so I think I'm just going to ditch that item. Maybe refresh it, in case I have to go through my options again. Also, you. I have to wait for you to go through. There you go. Okay, let's kill you this time. There's the key. And let's leave. We're up to room 85. We're very close. If I die, I will be upset. I definitely will. I wouldn't be happy to do this over again, but at the moment, I am having fun. No, not these guys. Okay, I'm going to wait for more of them to spawn. That's not enough. Ow. Oh, wow. Have to be careful. They deal a lot of damage. This would be the time to use a ghost shroom. I think. This will be the day we waited for. This will be the day we open up the door. I don't want to hear your absolution. Hope you're ready for a revolution. Okay. As I stop singing Ruby songs, I'm just going to get my ghost shroom here. There you go. Oh, he can block their attacks. That's nice. Whoa. Can you attack them? Maybe. Maybe not. Maybe that's asking too much. Nice. Oh, I just realized we can't tell what kind they are because they don't have eyes. Because their eyes are hidden. Well, that's kind of upsetting. Don't spawn on top of me, and we can coexist. Good. Okay, let's leave. Because since I have a ghost room and he's kind of stuck, it would be best if I left as soon as possible because then I can keep him. Even though I lost him anyway. Okay, now's the time. Thunder Rage, actually. Okay, shake it up and down. I do have a life shroom in case I get hit here. Otherwise, I'm just going to freeze time and then use my Mario dodge. But I think I might be able to kill him. Nope, I did not. Oh, boy, I had to hop off carry. Okay. Let's use another Thunder Rage just to clear it out of my inventory. Shake it up and down. Actually, Thunder Rages aren't that good either. They're dealing about 12 damage to each enemy, which is not enough to kill. I'm tempted to just burn through my items. I'm going to use a Shroom Shake, just because that would be useful. And then, yeah, I don't really need to do anything special here. I just got hit a couple times because of enemy layout. It wasn't anything that I was doing. The enemies aren't getting harder. It was just the layout. So it's nothing really to worry about. Although it should be noted that I no longer have proper healing items, so I need to be careful. Start my fire. Oh, never mind. It went down. Burn these guys. I'm going to be getting a level up very soon. Watch out for the shell rebound. It didn't come. It despawned. Very good. Okay, where's the door? As we have 700 coins. Wow. We have never had this many coins at any stage of the game. And I am quite happy to have this many. Okay, burn him. Burn him again. I don't want to be putting up with that garbage. That is literal garbage. Those shells are annoying. Okay, burn all of them. And you have the key. No, you don't. Who has the key? Who's holding out on me? Who has the key and won't tell me? Oh, it's you! Boyo. It's you, as I have... Was that... 11,000 to go until I hit my level up. So, that's something that's good. And I can definitely survive that long. In fact, if I could use Ice Storm here, because it's going to be hitting a lot of enemies. Have I used Ice Storm before? I don't think I have. It says it freezes enemies, but I don't exactly know what that... Oh, it deals damage. Okay. Oh, but it also freezes them. That's cool. That's a cool item, and... I mean, it doesn't deal a lot of damage, but it certainly is useful. The freezing effect is not to be discounted. Alright, we're probably going to be getting our level up here. So, if I can get one or two styles. If the game will let me get styles, there we go. That's better. It doesn't really matter that I'm taking damage because... Oh, wait. I thought he was dead. Never mind. It does matter that we're taking damage. Let's burn him. Very nice. We're so close. Three more enemies hit. Or three more enemies killed will definitely give us a level up. Which we can do, we can manage on our HP. Unless there are Magiblots. That's the only factor where I'm not sure. Okay. Switch back to Bowser. Whoa-ho! Don't call Kamehameha me, please. These enemies can be very difficult. Where's he gonna go? There. Burn. Yes, there's the level up. We're up to 60 HP. That feels good. Now, the key is, because I have no more level ups in my future. Maybe even, I dare say, for the rest of the main story, we will never get a level up. Because if you look at this, that's, well, maybe. It's 100,000. But I'm pretty sure in this area, we will not get another level up. So, the only thing I have to... Why is the term rest my laurels on the tip of my tongue? I don't know. The only thing we have to take... Oh, yes, is, take solitude? What's the fortitude? I don't know. The only thing that we have to look forward to are random item drops and Merly Charm. So, that's really our only saving grace at this point. We're up to floor 90. We're close. If Flim is here, I will jump for joy. I will actually get out of my chair. And I will jump. Is he here? No. I'm gonna flip. I wanna know. Is he here? Please be here. He's not here. Okay. What does it say about this? There's nothing in it anymore. I know that. Okay. And Flim's not invisibly here. He's not. Alright, it's time. It's time to take the final 10 floors. I have no clue how long this episode is. I'm pretty sure I'm going to get next to no views on this because it's long. And I have a poison shroom now. Good, I guess? Question mark? Let's see. Jump down, kill him. Turn around, kill him. So yeah, I'm probably not going to get another level up, but I think that I should... Oh, boy... Burn him. But I should be good. I should be good. I'm just going to be very optimistic because I do feel pretty confident right now in my own abilities. I don't know what the boss is. Well, actually, that's not true. I think I know what the boss is. I think I do. And knowing my stupid memory, I'm probably right. Oh, that's nice. Please be a healing item. What is going to be... Healing item! A very good one at that. I mean, it's no Ultra or the Green Shroom Shake, but it's definitely good. What are these poison shrooms? I don't want the poison shrooms. Okay, let's see. Go up here. All the way to the right. Fall down. Watch out for this curse, yeah? Woohoo! That was close. And kill him! Neat. I don't know what the poison shroom does, but I feel like it just poisons us. I feel like the game developers are not above doing that. Ow. I did not see that coming, even though I knew it was coming. I did not see it. I thought that I'd canceled it. Okay. Pal, do not become complacent. Kill them, and then burn him and grab the key. There you go. Good job, pal. That was close. I need to avoid every hit. I mean, even if it's one damage could very well. I mean, we've survived off one health before, so one damage could spell our doom. Okay, there are more of these, so I want to get to the high ground as soon as humanly possible. Burn him. Nice. Okay, now we're going to flip. Go to the other side. All the way to the other side. I mean, all the way. Nice. Okay. Hopefully we won't get hit here. We did. Okay, he's dead. There's the key. Oh, okay. Cheap shot. Cheap shot game. I see how it is. Okay, we're almost down to half HP. Once again, not getting level up. Things are getting a little bit close. So I'm gonna have to play on my A game here, and that's... My A game is not working yet. Okay. Come on, pal. You can do it. Okay, he flipped. I'm just going to ignore him for a while. See if I can root out any more enemies. Which I did. Oh, Sleepy Sheep. That's nice. That's actually pretty good. Kill him. Get frozen. Oh, there's a peach. There's a peach. There's a peach. Let me get the peach. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Peach. Peach, peach, peach. Peachy. Eat the peach. Up to 34. Grab the poison shroom. I don't know why. Maybe if I'm panicked, I'll eat it. Let's flip and chase after that little flower guy. Where is he? There he is. Hey, buddy. Okay, he flipped again. Okay, that's not fair. You can't hide in solid objects. That's not allowed. Got him. Just get a couple freestyles on him. Not because I expect to get a level up, but because I hope to get a level up. Are you really going to flip like this? Ooh, that was close. Hey, buddy. No. Really? No. Really? Buddy, come on. Come on. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Okay, I'm gonna wait. Desync him. Flip. Got him. I just kind of have to sneak up on him. Oh boy. Oh no! Oh, I took 20 damage from that stupid enemy. Die, please. I will die if I get hit by him again. I straight up will. Okay, let's heal up. That is overpowered and annoying as all get out. I will kill you and your family. You know what? I have an idea. Yes! There you go! Die! Like a flower should die! That was... Okay, I haven't had any problems with those enemies thus far, but those are very, very badly designed enemies. Like, that takes the cake for anything in this game. Anything in this game that has been badly designed, that takes the cake as the worst designed enemy I've ever seen in my life. An enemy that can flip and just keep dodging you while dealing... like almost half your health is damage, that's ridiculously overpowered. And is... no, that's not good game design. I won't let that one fly. Volt Shroom, I have a Volt Shroom. I'm gonna use a Volt Shroom. Okay, press the flashing button. Press the flashing button. Okay, don't let that one enemy throw me. I won't let that one enemy throw me off. It was just one enemy, and that's the second time I've seen it. So, it's balanced by the fact that it's very rare, but it's still a very overpowered enemy. Also, are you seeing the fun times here? Ice Storm. Shake it up and down. Let's see how many we can kill. A lot of them. Very nice. Won't kill him, but it will be a lot of death. Shroom Shake, that's nice. Goombas have good item drops, actually. Especially when you're starving like I am. I mean, if you can assume that... ooh, another one. If you can assume that HP is actually, you know, health, as in I'm hungry. It's hungry points. Then, I mean... I am hungry when I'm low on health. Though that's kind of not what it means. Also, I have 800 points. Are you seeing this? Please drop an item. No, but I got two Shroom Shakes out of that. So that's... oh, hey, buddy. And a honey jar. A very beneficial room for the PAL Association. The PAL Association is not responsible for any laughter that may occur, and is completely unintentional. Okay, more of these enemies. More of a very annoying enemy over there, that flying skull. Okay, let's kill this one. And... hey, buddy. Please let me kill you just real quick. Oh, snap. I tried to flip there. Okay, let's go in here. Switch to Mario. Ow. Okay, that's also a very badly designed enemy. Almost impossible to hit, takes no knockback, and I am very tilted right now. Okay, and he takes one damage, which is annoying. Okay. Please come over here. I need to remember that I can heal. Come on. Where is that enemy? There he is. Okay, now, while he's gone, I'm going to kill this guy real quick. Whoa, run. All right. Hopefully the key's in here. Okay, there we go. Throw the poison shroom. I don't need that. No, throw the poison shroom. And I'm actually tempted. Yeah, this is a good idea. Sleepy. No, it's not a good idea. Oh, that was close. Where is he? He's over there. What is he? You taunting me? Buddy? That's not fair. I can't taunt you. Ow. Speaking of annoying enemies, they're throwing all of them at me right now. Ow. Okay. I can take a hint. Honey jar. Just use the honey jar. Gain 10. And got two hits in on him. I just kind of have to act like I'm jousting right now, or fencing. There's the key. Also, I feel like now they're putting the keys in enemies intentionally, and it's no longer randomly generated. So I need to be aware of that. There's now a set order that they want things to go in. This seems like a very easy room. Almost too easy. Once again, I'm not getting level up, but I hope that I get a couple item drops. Okay. Yeah! Yes! That's exactly what I wanted to see. A super shroom shake. Just what I needed. Now I have a shroom shake, a super shroom shake, and how many? And three res items. Okay, so things are looking a little bit up. I actually haven't seen my Merlee in a while. It's a little bit concerning. I think actually my buff might have gone away. Throw away the poison shroom, don't need that. Okay, my inventory is looking much better. Oh boy. It's getting close. And I act like it's suspenseful, but it is suspenseful. I mean, it's suspense just stretched out over the entirety of this episode, which once again, I have no clue how long it is because I'm not using a timer, because otherwise, like, why would I use a timer? I'm planning on ending when I'm done, not, yes, I'm planning on ending when I'm done, not when a time has been met. This is good. It won't give me a level up, but it may give me a cool item. I don't know. Just take this damage. These enemies are really easy when you have Bowser. Let me scoot up a little bit. There you go. Also, I think they move their hitbox up when they charge, and that's what's actually hitting them. Okay, there's a lot of experience right there. Actually? How close? How close am I? I'm actually really close. I'm 30,000 experience. I misread that. I will get a level up in this area. Maybe. Well, I need 30,000. And so I may. Depending on what I see in the next couple of rooms, I might get a level up. This is nice. Also, oh man, the thought in my mind has been put, how long is this episode? Is it 2 hours now? It feels like it's 2 hours. Maybe that's just how long I've been recording, but it's long. Okay, he's dead, there's the key. All right, through here. Now in case, hopefully that HP bar isn't getting annoying, but I don't want to heal just yet. I don't know why I'm not healing, but I'm not going to. Okay, maybe I should. Okay, this. Burn him. Okay, he's dead. Props to my dodging. I want to start at the top, actually. I need to start at the top and work my way down, because otherwise that hammer bro will be very annoying. Okay, will you drop an item? You got a Thunder Rage. Everything helps. Which means I should use an item. Let me chuck this. Use the Thunder Rage. I'm about to get hit by a hammer, so I'm probably going to switch to a different character in a second to avoid the hammer. Actually, no, I think I can dodge that. Yeah, I can dodge it. Okay, now grab the Thunder Rage. Okay, and now I'm going to use the Sleepy Sheet. So there, when it flashes, hold the button. Very nice. I don't think I've gotten full charge on that one yet. Okay, let's use the Sheep of Sleep and show them the Fairy of Dreams video, and they're all going to fall into a deep slumber. There's my key, though it's not going to be that easy. I'm planning on killing these enemies. Ooh, that was close. And he's dead. I'm so close. I'm really close to a level up. I will get it. Okay, charge at me. Ooh, that was close. Burn the enemies. Burn him. Nice. And you too. I am so close. 1600 experience. Oh, wait. Need to be careful here. Be very careful. This will give me 1600 again. A level up's in sight. It's in very close sight. This is floor 98, right? I hope so, because then that'll give me a chance. It'll give me a chance to level up before room 100. This is room 100. It's here. It's happening. Okay. Oh, this is a really good inventory. Wow. Things are looking up. I've waited for you, heroes. Who's here? Who's running their gap? Show yourself, bub. Wait. Is it? Ah, you have done very well. Your bravery has not gone unnoticed. I am a servant of the ancients, sent here to give the power to the true heroes. You have passed the 100 trials behind you, but whether you are the true heroes of legend or not is yet to be seen. I will give you a new challenge. What? You can use this pipe to leave the dungeon. Then you can venture down. Wait, what? No. What? What? No. 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 Are you kidding me? Really? We have to do it again? I was not expecting that. I mean, I can. I can do it. Yeah, that's not that bad. I'll do it. Next time, we're going to be going through the pit of 100 trials for a sixth time? You know what, I'm flipping. I have a slight suspicion that it's a trick. Is it a trick? I thought that when we entered this area, that, it was Francis because of the weird flashy thing. I thought it was a camera lens, but no. All right, let's go through. Wow, okay. We didn't get a reward, so next time we'll do that. Well, at least I have some items to sell. This is actually a really good inventory. I probably could have taken whatever they threw at me with this inventory. So next time, we're going to be... You know what? Yeah. First, I'm going to do something. I'm going to do something right now. Actually, no, I'm not. I'm just going to end the episode. I don't want to keep you guys too long, and not all of you have watched it, so will watch this episode, so I don't want to throw something important at the end. I was going to be like, we're going to do our inventory right now, but no, we will do it at the beginning of next episode. I don't know if I'm going to skip out the pit. I might do that. I might skip out half of it. Actually, that sounds like a good idea, so that you guys can get a taste of it in case you didn't watch it. So, next time in PalPlays Super Paper Mario, we're going through the pit of 100 trials again. Except this time we're going there with a full Merlee charm. I'm not talking about this kitty stuff, the halfway point. We're going with the most expensive Merlee charm. I'm gonna look into the emergency rations that we can get that heal fit for 50 HP in the, or is it 100? 50 to 100 HP in the pits, and I am going to go there fully prepared. See you guys then.